I did a research in that area for about 6.5 years to look for the place of Migdal Edel. They had these little towers where they had birthing rooms. Mm-hmm. And that's where Jesus was born. He was born because he's the Lamb of God. He's born in that area. And so we get a full picture of Joseph and Mary. They went to Bethlehem, the Bible says, mm-hmm. and Caesar's decree. Mm-hmm. And they had to go register for taxes.
Right.
And so Joseph had lineage in Bethlehem, and he had to go to get taxed in Bethlehem, which is where Migdal Eder is. Mm-hmm. And we read in the Bible, and there was no room in the inn.
Right.
And so the average story is that they took Mary because there's no room in the inn, and she was born in some bay in some stall with a bunch of animals. But that's not what the Bible says. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
The Bible says there was no room in the inn for Miriam, for Mary. Why? Because the book of Leviticus says that if a woman is having an issue of blood
and giving birth,
she cannot be in the same area.
For a week.
And so when she came and she was about to give birth,
they saw it. She was screaming out there on the donkey. It was time.
And so it wasn't that there was no room in the inn. There was no room for Mary in the inn.
There's no room for you here.
It's God's master plan.
All the Jews were there. He's not going to let them in there.
And then they go on, and we know where they ended up being.
Yeah.
In Migdal Edel, the Tower of the Flock. And that's where Jesus, Yeshua, was born. And the Bible says swaddling bands. You'll find the baby lying in the manger, not in a manger, the Bible says. And for this reason, those priests knew exactly where it is. The Bible says, today the Savior has been born to you. And the priests knew exactly where
it was,
the shepherds. Now, I call them priests because that's what they were. They weren't average shepherds. Yeah. These were priests.
They were trained by the priest,
and they were going in to do the sacrifices of the lamb.
Okay.
Every day, because the Bible says in the book of Numbers, the Tamid offering. The Tamid offering is every day. So they were professionals in growing these lambs. So when Yeshua came, they were ready, and they knew exactly, you know, where this place is, this Migdal Edel. There's a lot of little, towers over there, but there's a specific spot on this
Bethlehem.
Area in Bethlehem.
Is that where the star was shining? Born.
And that's where it was. Now, it's all referenced, it's all documented in this book. It's backed up by scholars, it's backed up by scriptures.
Archaeologists,
and it's just, every time I go there, I get goosebumps. It's mind-blowing.
Don't go anywhere, we're coming back.
What he reveals in this book, again, he's not pulling this out of his back pocket. Number one, it's in the scriptures, and he shows you that. Number two, scholars have seen this and they've been writing about it, but the church has ignored it because it goes against so much tradition. Mm-hmm. Number three, there are big money interests because of the Chaldean spirit in Israel that own sites and property, and they make tons and tons of money on leading people basically to the wrong sites. Number four, it plays right into Satan's hands. Watch, I'll give you the example, tie a bow on everything he said about the birth of Bethlehem.
Okay.
Think about this. So they go to Bethlehem. We know the story in the Bible. She's turned away from the inn. Now we know why. It wasn't because that was the last room was just taken. No, he had room.
Yeah.
But he says, you can't be here. Everybody, you'll run everybody off. You're pregnant. You're going to give birth. We hear you screaming on the donkey out there, and literally. And plus it's Levitical law, and most of these people are Jewish people, and no, there's no room here for you.
Yeah.
Watch this. Because of blood. This world has no room for us because we're covered in the blood of Jesus.
True.
You hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So the picture's already been made. So then where do they go? They wind up at the Tower of the Flock, Migdal Eder, which is just right there, Bethlehem to Jerusalem, where the Tamid sacrifice, the daily sacrifice, those shepherds, as he just said, and we've got all of this backed up by archaeologists and historians and scholars, Orthodox Jewish people who have written about this. So this is not just stuff he's making up. It's just he's bringing it back to the church to get the truth in these last days. Watch, and you'll find out why. So these shepherds were trained by the temple priests to do what they're doing. They're not just ordinary shepherds out in fields or out in the woods with sheep.
Yeah, yeah.
These are in Bethlehem fields, designated specifically for since the first temple to feed those lambs, perfect lambs, male lambs, perfect in shape, no broken bones, to the temple every day.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a 4 or 5 mile trek both, right. both each way. So this was laborious work. But watch, you got fields full. Well, you've got towers built all over those fields. And the towers to watch for wolves and thieves and all of that. And the one at Migdal Eder, there was a birthing room underneath it. And
he's the highest one up there.
The highest one. They could look out. But there was a birthing room known as what we would call in our English a manger. It wasn't a barn. It was a place where they would take these lambs that were giving birth to the little ones, and then the shepherds that took care of them, because they got to deliver them to the temple at the proper time, they would wrap them in what are called swaddling bands. That word comes out of the Old Testament in several
places.
Book
of Job, chapter 3, verse 8.
Wow. And so they would wrap them to keep them from breaking their arms and legs. They were going to be sacrificed. These little, perfect male lambs with no broken bones would be sacrificed in Jerusalem. These shepherds were the ones responsible for that. Now watch. So more than likely then, because Micah 5 says he'll become the one who's from everlasting, from eternity,
right.
will be born there.
Yeah.
Okay. Isaiah chapter 9 has already said, for unto us a child is given, unto us a son is born. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace, Everlasting Father. So we know it's a male child. Now we know from Micah that it's in Bethlehem.
Yeah.
That's Micah 5. But Micah 4, as he said, right before it, has already said, it's going to happen. He's going to be presented to you at Migdal Eder, the Tower of the Flock, which is right there.
Yeah.
Now, there are Orthodox Jews to this day who know that's where they're expecting Messiah to come from. They reject Jesus, but they know that's it. When they see Christians running around, Messiah born here, Messiah born in this cave and here, and it turns Jews away because they're watching Christians go to all these fake places. That's one of the things Satan's doing.
Yeah.
But watch. So when the angels came and pronounced, watch what they said. Unto you in the city of David, Bethlehem, a child is born.
Right.
Okay. He is Christ the Lord.
Right.
And you know, and go to the place in, where he
and
is.
They went
and
in
then
haste.
It says, they went in haste to where the child was. They knew. As soon as the angels didn't say, now go to Bethlehem and go 4 blocks in and turn left.
There were a lot of towers there. How do they know which one?
Yeah, and the angels didn't say, now there's a barn over there and there's donkeys and everything, and that's where he's back in the barn. They said, go to Bethlehem. You know the place. Why?
Wow.
Because they're trained by the priests. They knew Micah 4. They knew Micah 5. And now the angelic host is saying, it has happened. And the Bible says, and with haste, they went to Bethlehem where the child was.
Mm-hmm.
And found him wrapped in swaddling clothes. They knew that was him.
Yes.
Okay.
Lying in
the manger.
Specific.
Mm-hmm. And so, now we have the whole understanding of not only was he a perfect lamb, but he was born as a lamb sanctified by the priest, because you see, the shepherds couldn't just take any old lamb up to the temple. The priests are not going to sacrifice any old lamb. It's exacting. It had to be an exact sacrifice. Jesus came and fulfilled the exact sacrifice, born in the birthing room, swaddled in the swaddling bands, witnessed by the priest shepherds, announced by the angels of heaven, right outside 4 miles down the road from where he would be crucified by the priests and the Roman government. And I'm telling you, it's all about, the scripture is all tied together. There's nothing missing.
Yeah.
Jesus said not one jot or tittle is going to pass away. Yeah. And what Zev is doing is just exposing what has been hidden by the Chaldean spirit. He's unmasking it so we can know our faith.
The book is called Unmasking the Chaldean Spirit. And you can get this on Amazon. You can go to Rabbi's website, or you can go to carlgallops.com. and get your copy of this if Amazon is sold out, and they are doing that and quite frequently, and that's a good thing.
Yeah,
that means people are getting the book and they're being educated on it. You can keep checking back, or you can go to one of their websites and get it. All right, so two things, and then we're going to move on to the Ukraine. One, there's a song that we sing every year at this time, and it goes something like this: "We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts." We traverse afar. Mm-hmm. And then you know the rest of it. But in our plays at church, in our dramas that we present and the songs we sing, we present it as though those three kings came directly the night the Christ child was born. Is that true?
Based on scripture, it's at least a couple of years.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, because the scripture says that when they came, they found the child, which is a different word for them than a baby infant.
Right.
They found the child in a house with his mother and father. Yeah. So they had, of course, eventually had to get out of the tower of the flock, the hotel wouldn't let them in while she was pregnant, and then the seven-day period afterwards.
Sure.
But they eventually found a house. We also know from biblical sources that Bethlehem, of course, was the heritage home of Joseph and probably Mary as well from the genealogies.
Yeah.
So they had some connections. Whether their immediate families were still there or not, we don't know. I don't guess.
They had lineage there, otherwise
but
they would
not
lineage.
Go there. So, and it was a small place, so they had connections.
Sure.
It's like if I go back to my hometown. I mean, I've been in Milton area for almost 40 years now, but still I have a hometown.
Right.
There are people there that still know me. Not that I'm all that, but I grew up there.
Yeah, sure.
So
sure.
They had connections. They got a house, and they were settling down.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't want to go back to Bethlehem, and this, again, he's got this in the book, and scholars say this. They didn't want to go back, to Nazareth right away, because look at the conditions they left under.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
She was pregnant before they were married, right?
Right.
And so they were they more than likely, they were determined to settle in Bethlehem, but the Lord had other designs once Herod was tuned into it all. That's okay. I told you turn that phone off, brother. That's why I'm stuttering through this part right here.
This is live television.
This is live television. So I got to tell them.
We had a hiccup there on Facebook, but we're going to make it.
Okay,
they are going to Egypt.
Yes.
Fulfilling the prophecy out of Egypt, you brought my son out.
Right.
Yeah.
So everything is fulfilled.
All right.
So the bottom line is everything that the scriptures speak of, that whole thing of Genesis 3:15, God tells Satan, out of the womb of a woman, I'm going to bring a male child that's going to crush your head. From that point forward, all the details are spelled out in the scriptures, and he fulfilled them right down to Migdal Eder, wrapped in swaddling bands to be presented as the perfect lamb.
And this Chaldean spirit has got many believers around the world going to the wrong sites, chasing shadows, chasing adventures.
Yeah,
you know,
pretty much,
itchy ears in the end times and gather around them teachers to teach what they want. That's what we're seeing right now.
So that was my other question.
Yeah, yeah.
Is we take these trips and we go to Israel and then we go to all these spots that, based on scripture, are not really there.
I'm going to say something that's going to shock a lot of people.
Okay.
And a lot of people go to Israel because they love Israel.
Yeah.
They love Jesus. They love Yeshua. They just don't know.
They don't know these things.
They don't know these things. They just, basically follow the tour guide.
Yeah.
And, there's a pattern of most of the tours what they do.
Sure.
But the truth of the matter is, why do people come to Israel? They come to Israel because they want to walk in the footsteps of Jesus, in the footsteps of Yeshua. They want to see where he was crucified. They want to see where he was born. They want to see where he ministered.
Right.
But
a
lot of times, without even realizing, they're walking in the footsteps of demons.
Whoa.
Because they're going in the sites that have been tampered by the Chaldean spirit, through Constantine, through Helena, his mother, through various things in history. But it's the Chaldean spirit operating behind the scenes.
A lot of people don't realize how much Constantine influenced the way we worship today.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
But
all happened.
But, God is God has a sense of humor.
Yes.
And Constantine really did a lot of damage.
Yeah.
But God said, I'm going to show you that I win the battle. I've won it before the foundation of the world. The lamb slain before the foundation of the world.
Right.
And most of the sites that have been tampered with in Israel are owned by the Roman Catholic Church. And there's a reason for that. I get into it in the book. It's all documented.
Yeah.
But the place of the resurrection of Jesus, Yeshua, is also in a Roman Catholic Church that never finished. They never finished building it because God said...
But it's not at the place where they present it now.
Because God said, you're standing on holy ground. I'm not going to allow it. Does the Roman Catholic Church have the money to finish a church? Absolutely.
Yeah.
But God won't allow it.
Whoa.
And so this is another picture of the defeat of Yeshua crushing Satan once and for all, Genesis 3:15.
Right. Right.
There are such a things in this world today known as tourist traps.
It's about that right there.
It all comes down to the money.
Yeah, and you know, they most of those people don't even have a clue when they set up those sites, the connections that have to be made through the scriptures. And the whole thing, one of the most heartbreaking things to me, again, I've read that book from beginning to end, which is why I was honored to write the foreword. One of the most heartbreaking things I read in there was about how so many Orthodox Jews, they know, they're sitting, they sit in corners and they laugh at the Christians and the buses that unload. Yeah. And they go and they get to that little cave in Bethlehem, they all kneel down and crawl through the cave. And they're not even close to it.
They're mocking, yeah. I know, because I used to be one of the mockers.
Wow. They
will mock, and so when you try to tell a Jew, don't you need to come to Jesus? They just laugh, they say, if you only knew.
Yeah.
You just crawled in a cave that ain't even where.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and you don't know the scriptures. Yeah. I mean, we don't believe Jesus is Messiah, but if you're looking for Messiah, he's going to be presented in Migdal Eder. It says it, and you don't even know that. You're trying to tell us to come to your faith, and you don't even know your faith. Right. I'm telling you, when you read this book, it'll just dynamically fill the void of the mysteries of God's Word, and it'll show you how it all connects, how great God is, how great His Word is, how everything was fulfilled and is fulfilled in Jesus Christ.
Wow.
Every jot and tittle, just like Jesus kept saying.
That's right.
Every jot and tittle, not one jot or one tittle will pass away from my word until it's completed.
That's right.
And so what one of the things he's doing is unmasking this demonic spirit and showing you some, he can't show you everything, but he's showing you the big major points of what the Bible says as illustrations of look how much the modern day church is missing and the connections and the power of the gospel and the power of the word of God. We're missing it because it's been obfuscated. It's been covered over in darkness.
Now Jews who don't believe in Jesus, don't believe in Yeshua, they don't believe that the Messiah could be born to a virgin. They don't believe in that until they have that Damascus Road experience.
Right.
And that's why the gospel has to go forth.
Sure.
But they do understand some scripture, because the Bible says in Romans 11 that the Jews have, or the Israelites have been blinded in part.
Partially. Yeah.
That means that they have some of the revelation, but they're blinded to some of the revelation. Why? So the nations can get salvation.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's time for the nations to bring the gospel back to Jerusalem and go home.
Yeah.
But in the process of understanding partially, they understand that the Messiah needs to be revealed in Migdal Edel, in the Tower of the Flock. We have scholars in Israel, one of them, Shuki Rice, who says this, Mashiach must be revealed in Migdal Edel.
He's quoted in the book.
They just don't know that he came already, but they've got one part right.
Mm-hmm.
And when they see the Christians going to Israel and going to the other places, they say, how are we going to believe in this Jesus and this Yeshua? They don't even know that Messiah is not supposed to be born over there, not supposed to appear over here. The Bible says Migdal Edel. Uh-huh. So it's so important.
And he wasn't crucified over there more than likely.
And so how can you preach the gospel to them when we got everything, you know, we're going to the wrong places?
It says the place of
this
the
This is
stone.
The enemy working behind the scenes to deceive the body of Jesus and to deceive Jews who don't believe in Jesus into not believing that he's the Messiah.
Back to discipleship. People have to be taught truth.